Merry Christmas, dear church, and blessings to you on this first Sunday of the Christmas season. A special welcome to those of you who are guests here today, whether here in the sanctuary right now, or live online, or later via recording. I'm Pastor Paul, and I hope we get the chance to know each other better in the days to come. Also, a special welcome this morning to our guest organist, Beth Christofferson. Hi, Beth. Great to be together again. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Thank you for leading us today. A few notes on the service. Today's service is a lessons and carols format. We've got the readings of the Christmas season with some carols in response to each. So it'll go lesson, carol, lesson, carol, lesson, carol. It's not a communion service. But the idea is that it's joyful and allows us to sing the songs of the season. Make sure we don't miss anything before we jump into Epiphany next Sunday. And so now, as God gathers us on this day of resurrection and new life, we prepare today for worship with the prelude. Please rise for confession. Amid the troubles and fears of this world, let us confess our sin and welcome God's forgiveness, grace, and love. O God, Mary accepted your call to be the mother of Jesus. Forgive our lack of faith and trust. Your son was born in the poverty of a stable. Forgive our neglect of the poor. The shepherds left their flocks and went to Bethlehem. Forgive our selfishness and complacency. With great joy the angels proclaimed, "Do not fear. For I bring you good news of great joy, Today is born a Savior who is Christ the Lord. In Jesus, who is Savior, Christ our Lord, our sins are forgiven. May you know the peace which the angels sang from the heavens. Indeed, God's forgiveness is good news of great joy. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, you wonderfully created the dignity of human nature and yet more wonderfully restored it. In your mercy, let us share the divine life of the one who came to share our humanity, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The first reading for today is from the book of Isaiah, beginning in the 9th chapter, beginning with the 2nd verse. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with the joy as of the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulder, the rod of their oppressors you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots and the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Amen. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quintus was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house of the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you.
In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord showed around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It has been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought the child Jesus to do him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all people, a light for the revelation to the Gentiles, and for the glory of your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed. And a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was a great prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage.
Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and bone.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, and yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Emmanuel. Please rise as we pray.
Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to God's people on earth.
Blessed are you, Prince of Peace. You rule the earth with truth and justice.
Send your gift of peace to all nations of the world.
Blessed are you, Son of Mary. You share our humanity.
Have mercy on the sick, the dying, and all who suffer this day.
Blessed are you, Son of God. You dwell among us as the Word made flesh.
Reveal yourself to us in word and sacrament, that we may bear your light to all the world. Together we confess the faith with the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in God's good news of great joy for all people, we offer our prayers for ourselves, our neighbors, and the world God loves. You inspire faith in our hearts and call us to rejoice with our whole selves at the salvation you bring. Make our churches places of belonging for all people in the fullness of their being. Raise up the gifts and the witness of people who are neurodivergent, living with disability, or bearing invisible illness. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Your praise is sung throughout creation in all times and seasons. As the new year turns, ground us in your changeless and sustaining love. Use the turning of the new year to inspire small habits that draw us closer to you. Keep us attentive to the rhythms of the cosmos and inspire us to live in harmony with all the earth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Give hope and stamina to leaders who work tirelessly for the sake of the most vulnerable. We pray for organizations working on behalf of children to provide basic needs, to protect from abuse and neglect, to address trauma, and to rescue from trafficking. We pray for organizations serving immigrants and refugees, and for all who work to bring peace and unity in place of violence and division. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Sustain all people who, like Simeon and Anna, have been waiting for salvation and wholeness. Especially this day, we pray for Lila, Dolores, Anthony, Marilyn, David, Bev and family, Brian, Christine, Jill, Meredith, Jane, Bill, Michael, Jamie, and the family and friends of Adam, as well as all those in need of comfort and healing. We pray especially for anyone also living with cancer or chronic illness, for all people who are in physical rehabilitation or addiction recovery, and those experiencing complications from long COVID. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let this community of faith be a joyful and inviting place for all ages and generations. Teach us to honor the wisdom of children, the inquisitiveness of youth, the thoughtfulness of adults, and the knowledge of elders. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
And we give thanks for all the beloved who lived with expectation and departed this life in peace. Sustain us in joy until we join them around your throne. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive our prayers according to your abundant grace. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
Let us pray. O God of justice and love, we give thanks to you that you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need, awaken us to the needs of others, and at the end, bring all the world to your feast through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. A couple of short announcements as we're sent. First is a reminder that Sunday school starts up again next weekend, January 7th. That's also the day we'll be celebrating the Epiphany of our Lord. So come ready to celebrate one more winter festival. And we look forward to the new year together. And now, as we're sent.
As God has gathered us and filled our hearts with the gospel, now God sends us forth to serve in mission. Let us pray. Gracious God, through belief in Christ and through the presence of the Holy Spirit within us, empower us to share the word, care and support each other in God's community, worship as a family in Christ, and be Christ-like examples to those whose lives we touch. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.